So today I'm going to show you how to turn all this junk into a fishing lure and hopefully be able to catch a fish with it. So flies are basically feathered hooks that mimic an insect or bait fish, and people use them in fly fishing to conceive and catch fish. But here in Singapore, it's actually quite difficult to do fly fishing due to the space restrictions. What anglers do is to basically attach a popper to their fly or a split shot to their fly so that we could use our own spinning or bait casting setups to cast the fly out and use it as a lure. Now this is referred to as spin fly fishing or popper fly fishing. Believe it or not, popper fly fishing and spin fly fishing is actually a very effective technique to use here in Singapore for peacock bass. In school today, I was thinking that instead of using your regular feathers to make your fly, why not use junk to make your fly? So that's what I'm going to do today. I'm going to try to use some junk, some stuff that you normally find in your garbage bin, and try to turn it into a fly fishing lure and see if we could catch any fish with it. So without further ado, let's get to it. So first of all, you need a lot of different types of junk, like some tissue wrapper, many different types of wrapper. You know, some wrappers have a more thin plastic layer and some has a thicker plastic layer, so you just want to grab a bunch of different types. You also need to get some stuff that you can't really find in a dustbin, like your fishing hook. I prefer to use a long shank hook, and thread. You could use your regular sewing thread at home, but to make it easier, I'm just going to use some fly tying thread and glue. You can use super glue as well, but for me, I have some fly tying glue, so I'm just going to use that. So I actually recommend you to avoid using flimsy type of plastic and use a plastic which has a more, you know, which is a slightly thicker and slightly stronger, such as the plastic you get from biscuit wrappers and such. And you can also consider the reflective surface of your wrapper or anything. This is because with a reflective surface, could actually reflect light in the water and you can attract fish more. So I'm going to show you how to create a lure right now. So the first thing you want to do is to basically cut off some thin strips with your wrapper. Now this will act as your feather body, and yep, so I'm just going to get to it. Now I recommend, like I said earlier, to use something like a biscuit wrapper, as it's more durable and you also have a nicer action in the water. So I'm going to cut the strip right now. You don't want to cut it too thin, you just want to kind of cut it just nice. So you just want to cut a bunch of this and set it aside. After that, you can cut a V-shape with something that has like a aluminium type of wrapping, aluminium type of packaging to it. Like, you can see that there's memory, and you know, you can cut a V-shape and basically you want to make something like this. And yep, so this will basically like be your middle portion of your lure. So you can try making the strips with some other wrap ring as well. This could give a more different color variation on the lure, which could make it look more attractive. So that's what I'm going to do right now. Okay, so now that you have your various materials ready, you could get to the tying portion of the fly. First, you want to just attach a hook to your vise. Now, you don't need a vise, you could of course do it freehand, but since I'm manning a camera while doing this, it will be better to use a vise. And you first want to just do a layer of your thread. You could cut it, but if you're using actual sewing thread, you want to tie a knot or something first. Then you want to take your strips and sort of cut your strips so that they have a pointed ending, like this. And you want to just slowly tie them on. Okay, so now I'm done with the tail of the fly. I'm just going to do some extra trimming here, you know, make the edges look more pointy and nice. And yep, so that will be like your tail of the fly. And to give the body some like reflection, I'm going to tie a piece of this and wrap it around the body here. and pull my thread all the way here and just use it to wrap it around like this. And finally, as a finishing touch, remember the body part that we made earlier? You just push it up like this, wrap it around your fly, and tighten it down like this. You can add some more pieces of, you know, your pieces of the tail to the body part, and we're done. There are many ways you could end off a fly. For us, when we do some fly tying, we have this tool and we basically tie a knot. But I understand that many of you guys out there do not have the luxury to use these stuff. So if not, you could actually search up for easy knots to end off your fly with online. And you know, after you're done tying it, if you're using sewing thread, you must make sure that you at least do a few more endings to your knot so that the thread doesn't come off easily. So you just want to cut it. So after you're done tying your fly, you could just use a dab of glue, super glue if you're using, just dab it on the head a little bit, and done, you're done with your fly. So now that you have your flies, let's put them to the test and try to catch a fish with it. Okay guys, so right now I'm at Kranji Reservoir with my friend Jared, and we'll be trying out the recycled flies, and I'm getting bitten by ants. I'm gonna show you the rig. So it's a very simple rig here that we're using, basically just a popper, or you could use a float as well, and just tie a uni knot or something and connect it to a leader all the way to your recycled fly. Okay, so guys, so all you have to do to work the popper fly is to cast it out and make small pops consistently, so the lure at the back will continue to move. So it's actually very simple to use, very straightforward and easy. You get used to it after about one or two attempts. And the fly at the back will basically act as some darting. And there we go guys, we just got one on a homemade recycled fly. That's like the second cast. As you can see, it works. It just works. Woo! I've got no intentions of bringing back the fish or anything. There we go. Okay guys, so that's it for the video. Hope you guys enjoy it, and I hope that you guys could give it a shot as well. It's actually quite fun, and it's very satisfying to catch a fish with something that you make. If you guys have any ideas on what other homemade stuff you want me to do, like a homemade popper or something, just leave it in the comment section down below. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And this is my friend Jared, me signing off.